So he's asking about altering your carbohydrate intake around the time of your workout. And this is something that's pretty interesting that a number of people have been doing. There's a period of time after you exercise, particularly after you perform intense exercise, when your body is particularly good at storing carbohydrate as the glycogen that we were talking about. It's really good at building up the glycogen levels in your liver and in your muscles and all that. And so there's an argument to be made for making sure that you eat some carbohydrate sort of in the first 45 minutes or hour or so after performing a workout to take advantage of this particularly good time frame for storage of carbohydrate. And so there are people who've been playing with eating a relatively high carbohydrate meal right after performing some kind of intense workout. They'll have a little bit of protein and fat there, but it'll be big on the carbohydrate. The thing there, if you're doing the zone, is you just have to realize any extra carbohydrate that you have there, you need to take out of the rest of your diet. You don't want to be eating the same number of blocks the rest of the day. So, you know, you can imagine, say I worked out right before lunch, I eat my 4 blocks of protein and my 4 blocks of fat, but I eat 6 blocks of carbohydrate. I need to then take some 2 of those blocks of carbohydrate out somewhere else for that day. So maybe, you know, take 1 block less here and my breakfast has a little bit less carbohydrate so that I still end up with 16 blocks of carbohydrate throughout the course of the day. And I think that's something that'd be really useful. I think where that's most useful is if you're gonna be exercising again in the 12 hours or so after your workout, because I think most of the evidence suggests that you store more glycogen in that period up, you know, till 12 hours. If an athlete exercises now and then eats some carbohydrate within the first 45 minutes, their glycogen levels will be higher than they would be if they hadn't eaten that carbohydrate at, you know, 4 hours after the workout and at 6 hours after the workout. By 12 hours after the workout, the glycogen levels, even if you hadn't eaten that additional carbohydrate, have probably worked their way up to about the same. So if you're just working out once per day, it's maybe not really necessary to do that. But if you're, you know, in a situation where you're trying to work out 2 or 3 times a day, which, you know, very few people find that they can sustain for any length of time. But if you're going to be doing another workout the same day, it probably makes sense to try to do this to really sort of help your get you that quick recovery so you're ready for that next workout. You're kind of spilling your M&Ms.